Hello students, welcome back to the third part of my lecture on photography and videography. All right, so in this part of video, we'll talk about camera movements. The first camera movement that we will learn here is the dolly movement of camera. Let me explain you first what dolly is. Well, dolly is a kind of platform that has wheels and it is usually used to carry camera in like heavy cameras that are used in film or television. In other words, it's a kind of trolley that carries camera. It has wheels and it can actually move because of the wheels, and it can also follow the object if it depends on the nature of the production. So if you remember, those of you who have watched the vampire movie that became quite famous after the release of the book Twilight, I think I actually don't remember exactly. Yes, I think that was the name of the book that is based on a vampire love story, I think. So in that movie, there is a part where vampires, they play a baseball game, and you see the camera seems to run fast with the characters in the scene. So that is, I think, a perfect example of a dolly camera movement. And in this picture that you see on the screen, there is a set. So whenever the camera moves towards the set, that is called dolly in movement. Whereas when the camera moves away from the set, that is dolly out movement. So this is about the dolly movement of camera. Now let's talk about the pan movement. Okay, before I start explaining, I want you to know that pan movement is actually the horizontal movement of camera. It can be on the right side or on the left side. When camera goes to the right side of the operator, that would be pan right movement. Whereas when camera goes on the left side of operator, that would be pan left movement. Next, we will talk about tilt movement. So tilt movement is different from pan movement in the sense that pan movement is horizontal movement of camera, wherein camera moves on right side or left side, whereas tilt movement is the vertical movement of camera. Camera can go up or it can go down. So you see, in this image right here, the camera is mounted on a stand, which is also called tripod. So in this image right here, the camera is tilting down. This is tilt down camera. This is called tilt down movement of camera. Here again, the camera is mounted on a tripod stand. And in this image, camera is tilted up. So I'm sure you understand what is the pan movement. The horizontal movement of camera is pan movement, whereas the vertical movement of camera is tilt movement. And there is pan right and pan left, tilt up and tilt down. Let's talk about pedestal movement of camera. So here again, the camera you can see is mounted on a tripod stand. So when the camera moves upward, it's pedestal up movement, and when it goes down, it's pedestal down movement. All right, so again, I leave this clip here, and now you can see the next clip, which is the fourth part of the same lecture, and in that clip, I'll explain you an assignment which is related to all the camera shots. And all the camera techniques that you have learned so far. For your picture assignment, you do not necessarily have to focus on the camera movements that you learned in the third part of this lecture. These were only for your knowledge and for your learning, but I'll explain more when I get to the fourth and last part of this lecture series. Thank you.